1 week from today, the sun will pull another disappearing act across North America, turning day into night during a total solar eclipse. And it's not just an historic sky show for those in the path of it. It's also a unique opportunity for professional and amateur scientists, including myself. But the Memphis Astronomical Society is joining us this morning. Their president, Jeremy Veldman, and professional astronomer Rick Honey here with us. Thank you so much.
Thanks for having us.
Okay, you guys have to just tell me about how do you feel about the excitement? What's going on?
Well, we've been waiting for this one for years, 10 years for me. And of course, it's been a little less than 7 years since we had the last one. It's a rare syzygy alignment where the sun, the moon, and the earth line up. But more importantly, it's an opportunity for you to get into that narrow band, that zone called the path of totality, mm-hmm. where all the action occurs. And it's so rare for it to come this close to Memphis. So with a little bit of effort, you can get into an experience that's otherworldly, essentially. So it's essentially the Super Bowl of astronomy. The sun comes in front of the moon, blocks out the light for a couple minutes during the day. You see the bright stars and planets coming out, Venus, Jupiter, Saturn. And it's just a magnificent spectacle. So that's what we've been waiting for.
Yeah, and what's going through your mind right now?
Well, I'm working with a expedition to provide live satellite imagery, live satellite uplink of the eclipse from its very early trek across the continent. I'll be in Torreon, Mexico.
Wait, what? Okay.
I'll be in Torreon, awesome. Mexico with a expedition from the Exploratorium Museum and NASA. And my deal, I'm the chief telescope driver. So I'll be there setting up some telescopes and getting ready to track all this in both white light and hydrogen alpha, I'm sorry.
Oh yeah, it's all these fancy words that we're now learning because we're all now amateurs. Okay, can you walk me through what we need to do to safely view and, you know, just experience this in the best way?
In Memphis, Tennessee, it's going to be a deep partial, so you'll never have an opportunity to look at the sun naked eye without protection. So you got to have your ISO-certified solar eclipse glasses if you're going to look at the partial phases of the eclipse, courtesy of American Paper Optics right here in Memphis, Tennessee. They're shipping about 75 million of these glasses. They're the number one distributor in the world. You can get them at eclipseglasses.com. We're giving them away for free in the next couple of days. We've got plenty of pairs left. So in Olive Branch and South Haven, April 2, April 4, you'll have the opportunity to get these for free.
Where are you doing? So at these locations? Okay, so guys, like, we had some from this exact Memphis.
American Paper Optics.
And when we said we had them, everyone in the building like showed up in the Live at 9 office and they were like, can I have 1, 2, 3, maybe 4? Okay, now also, why is it important to just experience this just from, I mean, this from an historic standpoint?
So solar eclipses, we've known for thousands of years down to the second when and where they're gonna occur. And what makes this tricky is the forecast, okay? It's ironic and cruel that we can predict to the second thousands of years in advance where they're gonna occur, but we may not don't know until seconds in advance where the clouds are gonna be. Keep an eye on the forecast. We need the help from our meteorologist friends.
That's a lot of pressure, Todd.
So yeah, we're looking for a hole somewhere, and you may have to work for this one because the advanced forecast is a little iffy. So we're expanding our options, including parts of the path that we did not know were even an option. But Rick being in Torreon, historically, hopefully, maybe it'll be clear there. And if you can't see it in person live, maybe you can see a satellite feed.
Yeah, and Rick, what do you think people need to know right now because we're a week out?
Well, if it's gonna clear up at all, and you know, you can watch it from Memphis, you can use solar eclipse glasses, but the difference between being here at 99% eclipse mm-hmm. and being in the path of totality truly is the difference between night and day. It will become nighttime in the path of totality. The sun goes away, and you'll be able to see the rare thing called the sun's corona. And the only way you can see that is for the moon to completely block out the light from the rest of the sun. And it's a beautiful thing to look at. It changes. You won't see it change pattern during the eclipse, but from one eclipse to the next, it's always changing.
Very quickly, name an app or some way that we can see it if there is a
Totality by Big Kid Science is probably the best app. Very easy to use, brings up an interactive map, gives you all the timings of duration and as well as all the contact points.
Say it one more time, Totality.
Totality. And it's free. It's in the App Store.
All right. Thank you, Jeremy Veldman and Rick Honey from the Memphis Astronomical Society. Thank you so much for telling us how to do this. And we're going to get our glasses, everybody. Right. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, first
guys.
All right. So, all right. You pretty much have an entire world or an area.
I was guilty. Remember when you were saying something about you found out you had glasses? And I said, can I have two, please? I'm ready. I need a couple of them also. And yes, we are watching for the clouds pretty carefully for early next week, because that path of totality that we're just talking about here is just like an hour off to our west. And at 99%, I think it's going to be pretty good if you decide to stay here. But it's all going to get started around 1 o'clock and will continue till about 3 o'clock. But I think it's right about 1:57-ish is when we're going to have the greatest eclipse happening for us. So yes, I'm watching the weather carefully. We're going to keep an eye on the clouds for next Monday. Hopefully we won't have any rain, no problems or anything like that, especially for this once in a lifetime event for most. All right, let's talk about today for a minute, shall we? The Storm Tracker 3S picking up the cloud cover across the area, and there is even a threat of severe weather back through the central plains. Now this is for today. Right now we have cloudy skies and a chance for a few stray showers, but nothing severe is expected for today other than these abnormally warm temperatures. Chances are good your air conditioner is going to be going on today. We're in the upper 60s to near 70 behind these southerly winds, and we're going to see highs back in the mid and upper 70s before the day is through. For comparison purposes, 76 yesterday's high, and throughout the day as we take you hour by hour, you see the cloudy skies, a few stray showers, southerly winds, temperatures trying to climb across the area. And even into the evening and overnight time frame, it will remain quite mild across the Mid-South, with daybreak tomorrow probably offering up the best chance of those scattered showers across the area. And with the breaks in the clouds, we're looking at temperatures trying to climb to near 80. It's that very warm, unstable air that concerns us with a chance for some showers and thundershowers. But it's looking like the cold front will be well off to our east before those temperatures start to climb. And that's why we're looking at the greatest risk of severe weather for tomorrow to be off to our east through middle portion of Tennessee, advancing out in advance of that frontal boundary. So again, we see the worst of the weather to our west today and then off to our east tomorrow. But in between, the rain chances will continue. Scattered showers for us, and the best chance is going to be at daybreak tomorrow, and then a chance of some stronger storms by tomorrow afternoon, the more you make your way off to the east. And again, we're talking about that severe weather threat off to our west with only a marginal risk for us. Better rain chances will be ahead for tomorrow, with rainfall forecast models not very impressed by this system moving across the area. So here it is on that all-important seven-day outlook. Breezy and warm weather continuing across the Mid-South, with the rain and shower, thundershower activity is most likely for tomorrow. Then by the time we get to Wednesday, we have the clearing and cooler weather ahead across the area with the 10-day outlook, including right here for the eclipse. We're talking about a 20% chance of showers. I need some help over here. What have we got over here?
Well, you know, we have the connects. We have a connection.
There you go. You hold that one. I'm going to put this one on right here. And again, do not look up without wearing these bad boys right here. All of a sudden, everything has gone away. These must be the
really good ones. I
literally
cannot.
Everything's gone. I even look at our lights here. I can't see those. But it is amazing and fascinating, and I certainly hope everybody has the chance to get out and see this on Monday, because it's just really spectacular. We had one just a couple years ago, and it was really great.
Yeah, and this is what? It's 7 years. So.
Yeah.
I've been always wanting to do this.
Come on over. Come on over the green screen. Here she is.
This is so embarrassing.
No, it's great. You're doing a good job. You can do the forecast.
Okay, still ahead.